fans in the house. A real hammer from back when they were made in Illinois. Back when Christ was a cowboy. And if Jeebus were to come to Earth now, it would be a good time. Never mind, here we are. I don't know. Oh, I just kind of feel like Fred Flintstone here, I'll tell you why. Okay, here's the gag with this. It's sat for a long time. I'm sure it was a cool bass once upon a time. The frets have been ground down to like ribbons. There is nothing there. I don't know what you do with that. The neck is doing this. And it's a set neck, so I can't take this off, right? I'm scared to look into cavity, but we'll get there eventually. Should I plug it in? Oh, while we're on the topic of things that don't work. Oh, fucking Christ. Yeah. Okay, never mind. We can make that work better. Anyhow, it's bent. But I'll show you what I see, and I'm scared, and I'm a little scared. You know, here's what I think. Have we got any Star Wars fans? So, remember like when the Millennial Falcon was so busted up that you never thought it would ever fly again? That's kind of how I feel. Maybe I'm Chewbacca right now. I don't know. Damn it. We'll just get a back shot of the Falcon here. But, you see, is anybody catching this right here? So that's the truss rod adjustment busting through the back of the neck. Which tells me that this thing has been cranked and cranked. We got a serial number if anybody wants to figure out. I think this is a real one, like, I don't know, 80s, right? 80s is when these were American made. These are interesting. All right, we gotta open up the truss rod thing and loosen the strings, and I'm a little scared on this. I'm sorry, but yeah, I pooped a little when I saw that. Okay, now it's time for a new YouTube channel. It'll be called Dave's World of Things He Didn't Break. Like, wow, someone's really had a fun time here. They loved it long time. Don't wear the skin off it. Okay, this is, you know, this is like an archaeological dig. So it's sort of, you know, Indiana Jones here, right? Opens up the truss rod cover. Some scorpion flies out, grabs him by the forehead, and he's poisoned, you know, I don't know. Oh, this is not looking really good at all. Ooh, what happened here? Okay, well, there's no string tension. And where's that spot? I gotta look here. This is just messed up. So this is cranked, I can see. I don't know if you guys can see that it's... Oh, this way, David. Truss rod's super tight. And the neck is still really bent. You see all that extra thread? The thing is pinned so badly that the wrench isn't deep enough to get... I can barely get it. We're going to loosen this off, but it's going to have to get heat pressed and go to the laundromat simultaneously. Well, it's not twisted, but it sure is bent, and the truss rod is released, so we'd really want straight wood. Anyway, this needs the heat press or it's never going to play, and even after the heat press it needs all new frets, and I'm getting old and tired, so stay tuned. Thanks for hanging out, folks. All the great links are below. below, 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 below. Cheers. Be safe. Be good to each other. Not to disparage. I haven't quit. We get that off of there. We're going to figure out where the neck is bent the most. Put some spacers under that. They push that really hard. We're going to heat press the shit out of this and see if I can straighten it out. Stay tuned. Cheers, folks. The only hope we got here is the old heat press. This thing is whipped. I removed the anemic, tiny little, peeny little, pukey little truss rod nut. Installed a few washers to pull that away from the wood that's trying to push it through, and put something on there that will clear the threads. We may have to leave that. Maybe we can go back to the other little guy. I don't know. Let's bend this. Right, we're going to bend this beyond straight, like as much as I can push it. Then we're going to tighten the truss rod and keep it there, and then we're going to cook it. Then hopefully, when I release it, after I heat press it, I'll have some truss rod movement, and I'll be able to straighten this out and put new frets in it, maybe. Like, frickin' maybe, okay? This is maybe. This is me over here. I was scratching my head about how to make this thing stand upside down, and then I found out it has its own built-in fall on your face, flat down, without hurting yourself, shape built in. That's what it's about. Now I get what the deal is. This is protection, right? For when you fall down and run into things, it keeps you from hurting yourself. I get it. Almost forgot, it's getting late. Now I crank the truss rod tight to hold it where we'd like it to be when that is tight. And maybe when I take the heat off it and I release that, it's gonna be somewhere in the middle, straight, sorta, kinda, open. Like I said, this is me over here. What are you doing down there, honey? Oh, I'm just cooking some ham-er. Be right up. Well, the heat press worked out wonderfully. And the wood is straight. So I'll just let that sit for a few hours just to be sure it's going to stay straight. We've got lots of truss rod adjustment now. Not quite sure if I'm going to put the small nut back on there eventually, because the truss rod cover will not go back on with that big sucker in there, but there's time. Don't worry. It's working. Well, it's been 2 days? 3 days. 3 days since I did the heat press. The neck is straight. I put the original truss rod nut back on there with a few spacers, and looks like we're ready to pull out all those old wires and put new ones in. I have the new fret wire, which I got after matching this stuff, and let's yank some frets. I think this is going to be really stinky. I'll do one here, and then I gotta put the fan on, and I can already smell it. So this is the way I do it. Be your own person. The way I start before I do anything is I make sure I can just grab that one edge and get started. That's enough. Now, rosewood. Do I have a chunk over here? I do. Rosewood is super freaking stiff, man. It's like, see how thin that is? A piece of a different material, I'd be able to snap that on the grain, no problem. So that's why it chips out, because it is really, really, really tough material. So we're going to heat it up a little bit. We've got a nasty old soldering pencil over there.
We're gonna put a couple drops of water up against the fret. Grab this guy. I sort of cut like a notch in it so it doesn't fall off the fret. Right? And we're gonna go along the fret, and you do have to tin this iron as well. And man, that is some stinky shit. And then when you see steam, we're gonna grab it and gently move our way along here. Don't get excited, because that's how you chip it out. I'll do one more from the side angle. And this is going to be warm, so we're just going to throw that over there immediately while it's still moist and gooey and all that. We're going to clean that up. We're going to resurface the entire fingerboard just to make sure it's good and level. Well, that's one I got. A bunch more to do. One more. Okay, once again, you're just going to see my hand more than likely. So I'm going to try and grab the edge just a little bit so I know I can get under there when I need to. Heat this guy up. That is rank. You can do it, David. Here we go. Yikes. He thinks these were glued in. I just see all kinds of gooey stuff. That's another reason I heat them up, because I don't know what these guys did, if they glued or just banged them in the spots. Looking good. Okay, I'm going to just take a break from the camera, turn on the fan, pull the rest of these out, and then I'll show you what happens next.
That worked out well. Now, experience tells me that you don't, I know it looks shitty, and you're going to go, well, let's just oil it now. Never do that. We're going to oil that at the very end. I'll show you what's going to happen next.
We need to make the wood portion as straight as possible. I got this little 4 thou. Could use 2, I guess. And a little slippage here on the 12th fret, and then we're back on top. I'll turn the truss rod a little bit and see if that comes out, but I don't think it's gonna. I think we're just gonna end up with a back bolt. I could be wrong. I'll take that. One more little tight and see what happens. We're gonna resurface this anyway, but we wanna make it as straight as possible before we go grinding away on it. I'll take that, but I want to look at it with my eyeball as well. Okie dokie. The neck is straight. Truss rod's adjusted, but we're wanting to, there's a little bit of inconsistency here, not much, a few thousandths of an inch. So this is just a piece of chalk. This is all going to go away. And I'm going to take the radius block. This is a 9.5 as per the radius gauge. That's enough of that. And we're going to just true that all up. Then we're going to clean out the slots for the frets and get the fret wire and start making it play like new again. This is 120. I'm going to go very lightly. There's a few scratches from whoever tried to grind these down before, and also I might have made a couple marks, and also we want to clean off all the goo. So once again, just to find out where I'm at, I'll I'll be back in a moment with a new grit of sandpaper.
Okay. I know it looks ugly, but don't be scared. It'll look beautiful once we put some linseed oil on it at the end. Right now, I want to clean all the slots. A lot. And then I'm going to take that guy and make sure the slots are all deep enough, because I'm going to guess maybe 8/1000ths of an inch off the top of the fingerboard to try and get out all the goo and all the marks and just make it all perfect. Once again, we had the straight edge on that. That's like a hockey rink. It's like an ice surface. But once we lost a little chip there. I'm pissed about that. But we can fix that later. It happens. What was I on about? Oh, cleaning all this out. And, you know, I'll get the wire out soon. Oh, and checking that all the slots are deep enough. This is weird. This is like a 9.5 radius, which I thought it would mimic a P base at 10, but nope, it's 9.5. Okay, you got a good shot of all the veins in my hand. I'll be back in a moment or two or three. I think I'm going to quit there for today, for a while. I hope everybody has a chance to join me for my live Friday night sandwich event tomorrow. All the great links to things that could help an old guy like me out are below in the description. Very special shout out to all my patrons. Everybody, please become one. You can phone me up and come over for a beer and go for a sandwich. And anyway, I'm still wondering how this is going to go, but it's going to be okay. Just sit low, drive slow, be safe, and be good to each other. This is very important. Cheers, folks.